Good morning and welcome to EMTV. This episode will all be about vaccinations. Joining us today, Erasmus MC's Head of Intensive Care Diederik Gommers and medical students Merwe Roussian, who already started vaccinating medical personnel. Some of you have sent us questions about the vaccine. Diederik Gommers will answer them later. But first, news of the week. The Dutch Student Union feels that the curfew is disproportional for young people. According to President Lyle Muns, it removes the last bit of freedom for students. Today, the parliament will vote if a curfew is necessary. If it is approved, the curfew will be implemented starting this weekend. Per January this year, employees will only receive a travel allowance if they are actually traveling to the office. Previously, all employees received a fixed amount of travel allowance per month, even if they work from home. This allowance will no longer be paid out. To get a travel allowance, employees must register their office days at ESS portal. For more information, read the complete article at erasmusmagazine.nl. Nearly one in three students are struggling with financial worries during the corona crisis. Students also drink more and use more drugs. These results were published in a report compiled by students from Leiden, Delft, and Utrecht. According to the survey, young people find the corona measures very tough. Stay put if you have sent us your questions regarding vaccinations, because we are about to answer them. But first, I would like to introduce our first guest. Here with me in the studio is Merwe Roussian, and you are the leader, medical student and leader of the student team at vaccination department at Erasmus MC. Mm-hmm. So Merwe, welcome.
Yes, thank you.
And your team has just completed the first round of vaccinations. Mm-hmm. How did it go? Did it went well?
Well, it was a big task, which we had to complete in a short amount of time. So at first, we set up the vaccination street, and then we hired people to administer the vaccinations after they had properly education. So most of them were students. And when we come to the vaccination street itself, it is divided in different posts. So at first, you get to registered at the registration desk. Then you go to one of the rooms and you get your vaccination.
Yeah.
So after that, you have to make an appointment for the second one. And we also had like a waiting room where we observed the adverse effects.
So it all went well.
Yeah, it went very well. And after 10 to 15 minutes, everyone was allowed to leave if they were okay. So yeah, that's how we set up the vaccination street.
And to give an impression of your work, you have made a little vlog for us. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look.
Okay. We bevinden ons nu in een van de kamers waarin er wordt geprikt. We prikken in vier kamers, vandaag ruim 130 mensen. We doen ons best. Zo ziet de kamer een beetje uit. We hebben dus een stoel, een computer om te registreren. En natuurlijk een tafeltje met de vaccinatie die we hier hebben. En het gaat heel erg goed. Iedereen voelt zich goed. Geen bijwerkingen nog gehad, geen pijn. Dus dat is helemaal top.
Oké. Nou, dan gaan we ontspannen je arm maar goed.
Ja, het is helemaal ontspannen.
Oké.
En dan komt er een prikje. Hoppakee. En dan voel ik wel wat.
Ja. En dan is hij klaar.
Zo.
En deed dat pijn?
Ja, nu wel.
Nee, hè? Gelukkig.
Top.
Voel je je goed?
Ik voel me nog steeds goed. Ja.
Nou, top.
Nou, Lieke, hoe voel je?
Helemaal goed.
Ja?
Was het fijn?
Ja. Nee, je voelt er helemaal niks van.
Oh,
echt helemaal niks.
Niet pijnlijk en
nee.
Ben nu al een paar minuutjes buiten.
En ik voel nog steeds niks. Ik voel me nog steeds helemaal goed. Helemaal.
Oké. Okay.
Gelukkig. Nou.
Over 21 dagen maken we een afspraak voor alle medewerkers voor de tweede vaccinatie. En dat doen we dus bij de afmeldbalies.
So Merwe, everybody looked enthusiastic in your department. Is this how the atmosphere is in general?
Yeah, well, I'm very glad it seemed that way, because even though we had to work very hard and long hours, there was a very pleasant atmosphere. Like, everyone was so happy to finally get vaccinated, and like they were like, oh, hopefully this will get us back to normal. So yeah, it was very motivating for us to keep continuing the hard work.
Yes, and joining us digitally is Diederik Gommers, Professor Intensive Care Medicine at Erasmus MC. Welcome, Diederik.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning. I haven't seen you, Diederik, here, so maybe... Yes, now I see you. Diederik, you already received the first round of the vaccine. Did you already start feeling or behaving differently after the vaccination?
No, that's not allowed yet.
Not allowed yet.
No, because the total protection is 1 week after the second injection. So that will be for me, I will be totally protected by the 1st of February.
Okay, so you are not walking around hugging and shaking everyone's hand?
No, unfortunately not.
Too bad, but it's good to know. And we already have asked students to send us their questions about the vaccine. And we received so many that we had to make a selection. And apparently, students are very curious about the vaccine and about you, Diederik, as well. So are you ready to answer the questions?
Yes, let's start.
Okay, the first question. How long will we be protected by this vaccine?
Yeah, very good question. We don't know yet, because the study started after the summer last year. At more than 20,000 people received the vaccine, the Pfizer vaccine, and later on the Moderna vaccine. And these people are followed. And until now, that's 6 months now, they still have antibodies in their after the vaccine, and we don't know how long it will be protected. So we will see that.
So we might get like the third one, or maybe we will get it annually?
Yeah, that could be, but we don't know yet. It could also be that it is protected for years, but we have to measure it, and we will look after these patients, and also all patients who are now vaccinated will be followed. So there is a lot of data coming on. In Israel, there are already 2 million people vaccinated, and also all these people will be followed, and this will give additional data within next year.
And do we need to worry about long-term risk? Because this student here, for instance, she asked if it will affect our fertility.
Yeah, everybody is a little bit scared, of course, because the vaccine is so developed in a very short time. But they don't have to worry, because long-term risks are very rare, extremely rare after vaccination. And with this vaccine, you are injected a small RNA, and this is destroyed within 1 day within your body, and it will not react with the genetic code of yourself. So the RNA is giving the information that these proteins will produce within your muscle cells, and against these proteins there will be a formation of antibodies, and also your body will react with a defense by creating T cells, and then these T cells will memory these proteins and the virus itself. So when the virus is coming in, the antibodies will be there, and they will be there for months. And after that, there is also memory cells that will help the defense mechanisms that, okay, this looks like the virus, and they will start by producing antibodies and so on. So no risk for long-term risk. It is extremely rare. It's not 0%, but it's rare. And it's the same for fertility. There are no studies. The studies are done in experimental settings, and these data didn't show no indication for fertility problems. And of course, also this will be followed within the next months.
Yeah. And by far, the most frequently asked question is, will international students get vaccinated in the Netherlands? Well, we contacted the Ministry of Health regarding this question, and the answer is yes. So everyone who lives in the Netherlands and is registered will receive a notification for vaccinations. And when, you asked? Well, it depends on which group you belong. Most of medical personnel like Diederik and Merve have already had their first shot, and people from the age of 18 to 60 with a medical condition will receive a vaccination call at the end of February, and the healthy ones can expect a shot from April onwards. So the plan is that everyone will have been vaccinated by the end of October this year. Correct me if I'm wrong, Diederik.
No, that's correct. Okay. And that of course, it depends on the speed of delivery of all these vaccines to the Netherlands. There could be some delay. But let's hope that the companies can really deliver their amount of vaccine as promised.
Yeah. And Merve, you might be able to answer the next question. Mm-hmm. So medical students who are going to do their internship, do they get vaccinated beforehand?
Well, unfortunately, this is not the case yet. And I got vaccinated because there was some spillage, so I was lucky. But yeah, the interns will not have their vaccination earlier. So maybe this will change because they work in the hospital. Yeah. But yeah, I think that's above my pay grade.
Yeah.
Maybe I can give some additional information, mm-hmm. because when you are working in the hospital, you didn't have additional risk. The risk for getting the COVID virus is comparable with normal people. And the highest risk is at home, and when you meet other people, because in the hospital, we are wearing protection equipment like the mouth mask, the gloves, the overcoat. So people who are working in the hospital do not need the vaccine. Only we did it for the ICU people because someone gets ill in the home situation and we can't miss the nurses in the near future due to the bright British mutation.
Yeah. And Diederik, the next question is about the curfew plan that has just been announced. So a student said it made her worry about new mutations of the virus. Is this legit? Should we worry about the mutations?
A little bit. But mutations are normal within viruses. That every time they are replication, during the replication process, they have a small mutations, and sometimes the mutations they are not that active, and sometimes the virus has an advantage of the mutation. And in this, with the British virus, they are more susceptible. People are more susceptible now, and there is more transmission. But at the moment, we still believe, and there are some data, that the vaccine is still working against the British mutation.
Okay. And Diederik, the biggest question of all, when will this be over? Because many students ask us, when can we start living again?
Yeah, that is so important. For us, the overflow of the hospitals will be stopped when all elderly people as above 60 years are vaccinated. And that's around 3.5 million people in the Netherlands. So that will be by the end of April. And thereafter, all other people will be vaccinated. So I really hope that we have back our lives at the end of the summer vacation, and maybe a little bit earlier, I hope so.
Oh, that gives me hope as well. So, but Diederik, since the corona crisis, you have gained somewhat celebrity status. And one of the reasons you became quite famous in the Netherlands is your remarkable skill to talk to corona skeptics. So I'm also asking for a friend here. Do you have any tips on how to start a conversation with family or friends who don't believe in the vaccine or even that they don't believe in the danger of the virus itself?
Yeah, important is everybody has a little bit fear, and someone has a little bit more than the other. And therefore, it's so important that you talk with each other and that you try to explain or that you ask what is the real problem. Of course, you can say everybody should follow the general measures, but sometimes there are different problems. People are lonely, or what you described, have financial worries or using more drugs. So that and then, of course, they like to escape. So most of the time, there is a different reason for it.
Okay.
And therefore, you should ask for it. And we should solve the problem with all the people. So please have attention for each other.
Yes, and so we have to seek the roots of the problem first.
Okay. Yes.
And Merve, how do you handle this? Is this an issue among medical students?
Well, it is not an issue which I see in my team or among medical students. So they are, to be honest, standing in line to get the vaccination as soon as possible. So I think that's probably because we have a lot of knowledge about how vaccinations work, and we...
The fear is not there.
Yeah, so, and also there are the restrictions which have a lot of impact on our lives. And besides this, I think we also are very aware of the complications COVID can cause us, because we see these patients on a daily basis, for example on the intensive care.
Yeah, so you just want to get over it as soon as possible. Mm-hmm. And you also told us, Merve, that besides your study, you work a lot.
Yes.
How do you manage to keep the sanity?
Well, to be honest, sometimes it
you
is
don't.
Very hard, yes. But I think it's the positive reactions that you get a lot, which gives you the motivation to continue. And also, I'm very thankful to have the opportunity to help the hospital in times of need. So I think it's a lot to manage at the same time, but it's very important to plan your time efficient.
Yes. Yeah.
So, but also it's that I get a lot of support from family and friends, so they keep an eye on me and make sure.
Okay, it's also important.
Sure,
yeah. Yes. And Diederik, I believe you lead a very busy life. How do you get through this time and stay mentally healthy?
Sleep enough, that's important for me, and the work is a lot of fun because I'm meeting a lot of new people. I like my work, so it gives me a lot of opportunities, and that's great.
So you sleep like 8 hours per night?
Yeah, I try to, and it's more normally in the daily week it's more difficult, but in the weekend I take some more hours.
Okay, that's a good tip. And during the press conference yesterday, our prime minister joked that there are no curfew for late night talk shows so that you can still join them. So next to being a guest at talk shows, what are your plans in the evening if the curfew is in place?
No, I stay at home as much as possible. And of course, I like to explain my knowledge to other people in the hope that everybody follows the general measures. That's, of course, important. Or that I can give some explanation about the vaccines. But that's all. I'm not interested to become a well-known people. I will disappear after the COVID is gone.
Yeah, but you don't adopt a dog so that you can walk around at night with your dog?
No, not necessary.
Okay. Well, Diederik Gommers and Merve Roesjen, thank you both for joining us and taking your time to answer the questions for our students. And I want to end this episode with a video featuring my biggest enemy, Excel sheets.
9.5. September 5th, 2000 at 12 p.m. Let's try that again. Okay.
Thank you all for watching. EMTV will be back next Thursday, 9 a.m. Go to erasmusmagazine.nl for the latest news.